The Dow plummeted 376 points today as traders grabbed profits and worried about the financial crisis in Greece spreading. Meanwhile, the U.S. Senate tonight has passed the biggest overhaul of financial regulations since our grandparents were young. Charles Jaco has more on what all this means to us. Charles.
Well, Sandy, these are the toughest new regulations on banks and financial institutions since the Great Depression, and it was even, surprising for Washington, a little bit bipartisan. Two Democrats voted against it. Four GOP senators joined the Democratic majority to pass it. The only thing more unpopular than Washington these days is Wall Street.
America wants this change. America knows what's happened here. The Wall Street banks got away with murder, and the taxpayers were left holding the bag.
As we've learned in today's economy, we're all connected. When the economy prospers, we all win. When the financial sector operates under sound rules of the road to ensure fairness and stability, we all win. Every American has an interest in a healthy financial sector.
But anger at Wall Street and Washington rhetoric aside, what does this bill do? The Senate proposal restricts bank trading in complex financial instruments called derivatives. They were largely responsible for the 2008 crash. The legislation says tax dollars cannot be used to prop up large financial institutions. It gives the Federal Reserve new powers to oversee banks, and it creates a new pro-consumer super agency designed to protect consumers in cases ranging from mortgages to credit cards. But opponents say this bill is dangerous.
The arrogance of this approach to governing is truly astounding. It uses this crisis as yet another opportunity to expand the cost and size and reach of government.
The so-called reform bill will actually punish Main Street America, the families who suffered from and not caused the financial meltdown.
The Senate version is different from a financial regulation bill passed by the House, but it looks like some final form of financial regulation could be law by July. Now, one interesting sidelight, another vote is tentatively scheduled on a proposal that would say automobile dealers cannot be regulated by the new consumer agency. Reporting live, Charles Jaco, Fox 2 News.